Okay, in the last lecture, we have been seen about the what is the big data, and we have been also seen about the solutions of the big data in the form of the HDFS and MapReduce. The big data is in the last lecture, that whatever we have been discussed, just is revised first. So normally people using the database for storing the data, but there is total four main V problem which introduce the problem with the data, that is called the volume, velocity, veracity and variety, right? And this problem is called as a big data, right? To solve these problems, we have two architectures. One is a Hadoop, that is also called as a framework. We have a two framework. One is a Hadoop framework, second is a Spark framework, right? So in Hadoop, that we have been also discussed, that Hadoop has a two main tools. One is a HDFS and the second one, that is a MapReduce. Right. Even we have been also seen about the Hadoop, that some of the terminology that we have been discussed with the HDFS, that is the distributed file system and centralized file systems. We have been also seen the difference between the centralized architectures and distributed architectures. We have been also seen the difference between the OLAP and OLTP. We have been also seen some of the keys, some of the keywords like the scale in, scale out, scale up and scale down. We have been also seen about the horizontal processing and the vertical processing. Even when with these all the definitions, we have been also discussed about the version of the Hadoop. Normally there is a three versions we have been discussed earlier, that is Hadoop 0, Hadoop 1 and Hadoop 2. Right now in the current market, the Hadoop 3 is also there, but the most stable version is called the Hadoop 2.7, which currently most demanded into the market. In Hadoop 2, they have introduced the YARN framework, yet another resource negotiator, that is YARN framework, YARN, right? That we discuss later on. But in Hadoop version 0 and Hadoop version 1, both are a similar kind of versions. They haven't so much different. That we have been discussed earlier. We have been also discussed that who will provide the Hadoop, who will provide this framework. So basically the Apache Hadoop is provide this. The Hadoop is a framework, right? So Apache Foundation or Apache provide this Hadoop. It is open source, anyone can use. Second one, that a cloud era which given the Hadoop with some modifications, or we can call the customized form of the Apache Hadoop. It is called the, it's provided by the cloud era, it is paid version. Right, then Hortonworks is also there, which also provides the customized version of the Hadoop. But as far as the comparisons with these all the versions, that the normal Apache Hadoop and Hortonworks Hadoop, they have a minor difference that done by the Hortonworks, and they have introduced their own Hadoop, that is HDF, Hortonworks Distributed File System Processing. Or we have also HDP is the short form, that Hortonworks Distributed Processing Frameworks. It is HDP. But when we compare in with the cloud eras, the cloud era have lot many Cloudera have done the lot many customizations which not available in the open source, right? And that's why it is most demanded into the industry. And the third and the fourth one, that is MapR. MapR is a new company which also trying to customize the Hadoop and is provide that customized version to the industry right now. But the most demanded in the industry, there are two main version is that. One is Cloudera and Hortonworth. As for the budget, economical issues, requirements, and the data, people are using the that Hadoop frameworks, right? So today we are totally discuss about the HDFS. We are discussing in very much details about the HDFS. So HDFS that we have been discuss about, that HDFS is nothing but the Hadoop Distributed File Systems. Now there is someone also called as a DFS. Hadoop is also the HDFS is certain name is HDFS is HD. It also called as a. So we are discussing today totally on HDFS. So HDFS is called as Hadoop Distributed File System. HDFS, right? That we already discussed earlier, the definition part. It's also called, or it can also called as a DFS, the Distributed File Systems, right? Now the first and very important thing that we need to understand, Hadoop is able to run onto the Linux frameworks. It's not for comfortable for the Windows platforms, right? That is very much important that keep in mind that Hadoop is comfortable with the Linux platform, with any version of the Linux. You are using the Red Hat, you can use the Fedora, you can use the Ubuntu, whatever you want, but or even CentOS. Normally Cloudera is working onto the CentOS. CentOS version 6.0. Right. So what the HDFS does? So we are discussing now. So HDFS is nothing but the when a data set is outgrow the storage capacity of the single physical machine, it becomes the necessary to partitions across the number of separate machines. That means what? Suppose we are taking one examples. We have, this is our a storage unit where we are actually store our data. So here we are just, our data is came over here, right? So we can call the data, right? All the data came over here. The capacity of this storage unit is suppose 250 GB, right? So we can call of 250 TB, even we can also call as a 250 TB. But the data is frequently came, that we have been already discussed in the earlier, because that is our actual problem with the big data, right? Because the data is voluminous and is came in a very velocity and veracity mode. We don't know which kind of data will come, we don't know how much speed of the data will come and which size will come, we don't know. All other uncertainties there. Big data is all upon the uncertainty, it's all upon the data. The data will came. Somehow your capacity is only 250 TB. Data is frequently came. Now somehow what happened, that the capacity of the storage will fill your whole storage unit is full right now, and still your data is came. Continuously coming the data toward your storage unit. Now the next issue is what? That where to store the data? So if we discuss about the centralized architectures or the normal database storage systems, so what happens, that you need to update your hardware, you need to update your configurations of your computers. So right now we have 250 dbs. So I might be configured with the 500 dbs. But this is not enough, because you can't say that now one word or after this much time my data will not come. Data will definitely come. And every day the data was increased as well. Every day your data will be increased. Right. When the data will be increased, that means obvious you need the storage. Right. When we have been also seeing some comparisons last time, that when the Facebook was started in 2008-09, how much user was there, and right now how many users is there. Even the last, we have been also compared the 2 years data, 2017 and 18, the last lectures, that what happened. And the 2017 9 lakh users are logged into the Facebook, and in the 2018 there is a 973,000 users are logged in, and maybe in 2019 it's more than 10 lakhs per second. We are talking about the per second. That means my data is frequently come into the storage systems. My capacity is enough. So what we need to do, if we are not following the HDFS, if we are, suppose we are just imagine that we haven't this kind of concept of the HDFS and Hadoop, so what happens? Just we need to reconfigure my hardware every time. 250 dbs, then we are configured with the 500 TB. Again my data, obviously it will be term, storage will be full, again I will configure with the 1 PB. Right, so data always will be term, and you need to always be customized, or you need to always be reconfigured your hardware. So you can just imagine that how many cores will be there to configure your server every time. You need to configure every time your servers with the space, speed and everything. Because when the data will came into the large unit, the storage is only not sufficient part to store the data. You need to also the process the data onto the same machine. So that means you need to configure whole hardware. Right. That is the big issues which faced by the normal database systems. Now what the HDFS, what the Hadoop do? Hadoop provide the distributed architectures for storing the data. And for the processing data, we have a MapReduce. Right. Two concepts the Hadoop provide. The one is the storing for the data, we have a HDFS, and for the processing the data, we have a MapReduce. Right. We have two main concepts. Now, here in normal RDBMS, for the storing and processing, we have a central systems at where you need to store the data as well as you need to process the data. If we have only one container where you need to store the data and you need to process the data, so somehow what happened? The data might be late, failure will be occurred, anything may be possible. And the possibility of this, mainly the failure, is very much high when you are doing all the thing at the one place. But what the HDFS do? HDFS do this, provide the distributed environment where if suppose your capacity of the hard disk is full, don't worry. Just connect the another machines with your server and store the data at where. That means we have a, this is our server, this is one computer where my data is stored. If this will full, what happen? We have another computer which is connected with it. This is another computer which is connected. This is another. This is another. And now suppose it will full, it will move over here. It will move over here. It is move over here. It is move over here. Just you need to connect the data. Just you need to connect the computers. You do not need to reconfigure the hardware. If the data will come, data is not sufficient for, you haven't the a sufficient space for the storage the data, don't worry, just connect another computer with it and store the data at where. Right. So that's written over here. What they returns when the data is that, we are not talking about the data, because we have been already discussed here that Hadoop is working with the large data. Large data means large data set. You are not able to, we are discussing again here as well. But keep in mind that Hadoop is not for small data. If you want to process only 1 byte of data, if you want to process only 1 KB of data, 1 MB of data, no. Hadoop is not for that. You can do. That means not the answer that you can't. You can. But your processing time, it will take the same time which taken onto the large data set. Right. So better to process a small data set over here. Hadoop is suitable for only a large data. That is keep in mind. So here what they written that when the data set outgrow at the storage capacity, we haven't the storage now because my data is outgrow. I have lot many data as compared, we haven't so much storage capacity. Now what to do? This situation occur where? The situation will occur at on single machine. You can see here that we have been written about the, this situation will occur onto the single physical machine. Right. Now what to do in HDFS? It becomes the necessary to partitions it across the number of separate machines. Now what it'll do? The first thing, all computers, we have a lot many computers. This is one computers. We have another computers. This is another computers. We have another computers. We have another computer. We have multiple computers. Right. We can call all are the interconnected. Because the networks will be there. All are into the network. We can call the all are into the network. Now suppose we have 100 MB, 100 GB of data. We have 100 GB of data. Right. We have 100 GB of data. And all the computers have a capacity of 15 GB. All the computer has a capacity of 15 GB. So just I am written over here that all the computer have a capacity of 15 GB. Now just amazed that we haven't this kind of architectures and we have only one computers with capacity of 15 GB. So it is possible to process this data over here. So it is no. Why? Due to less storage capacity. Now same over here, we have 5 computers, all have a 15 GB capacity for storing the data, but we need to process the 100 GB. So what HDFS do? HDFS will distribute this 100 GB into the 5 machines. So each machine had 20 GB. So this 100 GB data store over here, only 20 GB of data. Out of 100 GB, only 20 GB will data store into the machine number 1. Onto the machine number 2, again 20 GB. Onto the machine number 3, again the 20 GB. Onto the machine number 4, again the 20 GB. Onto the machine number 5, again the 20 GB. All the 100 GB are sent. And still, all the computer have a space. All the computer have still a space, it able to process another 600 GB of data. Right or wrong? This is the concept of distributed file systems, where your data distributed among the multiple computers. And suppose you are not using the distributed file system, so what happen? All the data storing onto the central machine or a central machines. But if we are using the distributed file system or distributed architectures for the storing, that means my all the data will distributed among the multiple computers, or we can call the multiple storage unit, and then all the storage unit here we call as a node. What we are calling? That is a node. Right. And where all the node are stored, that is called the rack. It's called the rack. One cluster has a multiple rack. Each rack has a multiple node. Node is called as a computers or the storage unit where your actually data are stored. Clear? So Here, when the data set outgrow to the storage capacity of a single physical machine, it becomes necessary to partition it across a number of separate machines. That point should be very much clear that we have been discussed that to better to store everything at one place on a single machine, we are distributing that all the data across the multiple machines. That is the point of the first statement. Now, second one, the file system that manages the storage across a network of machines called the distributed file systems. That we haven't discussed just a minute ago. What we are discussing that all the computers, all the storage units are connected through the network. Then and then we are able to access the data from computer 1 as well as computer 2 as well as computer 3. If all three are from different locations and they are not connected to each other, so how it's possible? We are not able to process that data. For processing the data, the compulsion is what? That all the storage units should be interconnected with the help of the network. Network might be anything, LAN, WAN or WAN. But that is compulsion that your data, where you store, that all the computer, that all the storage units should be interconnected with the help of the network. That is our compulsions. Right. So what they written, that file system that manage the storage across the network of machine are called the distributed file system, since they are network based. All the complications of network programming thus making distributed file system more complex than regular disk file system. For example, one of the biggest challenges is making the file system tolerant node failure without suffering data loss. Normally, what happened in file system, what they are written that in the distributed file system, one of the big problem, a major problem, now it's introduced. It said that it's good that everything are storing at the different storage systems. Now, suppose we need to access we are taking the same examples. We are storing the 100 GB across these all the file system. All the five different storage system by distributed in 20 each. Now suppose we do a reverse. I need to access that 100 GB of data. Now what I need? I need 100 GB of data which I have been already stored in five different storage machine. Now I want to access the same 100 GB back. Are you understand? First, what I have been done? I have been done to store the data across the file machine using the concept of distributed file systems. Now my second point, now what happened? Now I require to access that data back. I want to read the data. I want to use that data for the some analysis work. Right. So when I am trying to access that 100 GB of data, I immediately get one news that my one computers are failed. One or two computers going to be failed, where actually my data was stored. Suppose the computer 1 going to be dead or failed, or computer 5 going to be failed. Out of 100 GB, where actually my 40 GB was stored, that two computer or two storage machine is not able to process my data due to some failure. Because we are using the distributed file system. All the data stored at the different machines. But when I need to access the data, that means all the five storage units combined to each other, and then it will serve to me all the 100 GB of data. But out of these, my two storage units are not working. Due to some failure, any kind of failure will be there. Internally, externally, electric, whatever happens. But due to some failure, I am not able to access in that two computers of data, which I have been already stored. This problem was happened into the distributed file system. Normal, in normal distributed file system, this is the major problem will occur, that where you store your all the data from the different storage unit, but some of the failure will occur, then your data will be lost. Now what to do? So Hadoop provide the solutions by introducing the concept of replications. The concept is called the replication, that we discuss later on, but that is the concept that Hadoop provide as a solution of the HDFS, right? So the Hadoop come with the distributed file system called the HDFS, which is stand for Hadoop Distributed File System, that we discuss. Now if we are talking about the Hadoop Distributed File System, so Hadoop provide the three kind of file systems that we need to understand. I think I was missed to teach you. So Hadoop provide the three kind of file system. Hadoop have three kind of file system. One is standalone, then pseudo distributed mode, pseudo distributed distributed file systems, and third one is fully distributed file systems. Hadoop provide three kind of file systems. One is a standalone or single, we can also call as a single file systems. Second one, pseudo distributed file system, and third one is a fully distributed file system. We are not able to implement the fully distributed file system over here, right? Because we need to configure our computers, all should be into the network, right? And where I am, my computer will become the server, your the computer become the host, right? So this kind of architecture we need to establish in the fully distributed architecture. This is not our work, this is work done by the HDA, we can call the Hadoop administrators. HA, Hadoop administrator, is responsible for this all the work, right? For configuring this all the distributed environments. Standalone is also we are not using, because all the thing will turn onto the single machine, where your machine will become the server as well as your the host, right? You are feeling like that we are using the Windows, where in one drive we are storing everything, and you can't feel the Hadoop environment, Hadoop frame, we can't feel the Hadoop frameworks. So we are using the pseudo distributed mode. The pseudo distributed mode is also working onto the single machine, but it feel like we are using the distributed environment. It is not a distributed, but it given the feel, right? So that we are using the distributed environment, right? So in our, as far as the practical concern, we are using the pseudo distributed mode, right? So we can feel that we are using the distributed, but it is not distributed, but we can feel that. If suppose I was used the distributed, suppose I will use the distributed, so this kind of what will happen, right? So that we can feel by implementing the pseudo distributed mode of the file system of Hadoop, right? So that we will implement the pseudo distributed mode, right? So that is one point that remained from us to teach you. So that we have been completed. Now again come back to the Hadoop or HDFS. So HDFS is also called as the Hadoop distributed file system, right? So there are solutions that the normal distributed file system has a problems. The problem is what? The problem was the node failure. The major problem is, suppose your data, suppose your one of the storage unit will be failed, the data will be lost. This is the normal, the problem of the normal distributed file system. Now the solution provided by the HDFS, the Hadoop distributed file system, with that given the concept of the replication that we are discussing. To the design of HDFS, to the HDFS is a file system that designed for storing very large file. Again came the same point that we have been discussed earlier, that Hadoop for only a large data set. You should keep in mind that Hadoop is able to process a large data set. It is for the large data set. That means not for it, not able to process the small data. It is. It can do, but we are responsible that which kind of data we need to process in the into the Hadoop. So as per the definition or as per the current requirement of the Hadoop to process the large data set. So then the same point here we are discussing that HDFS is a file system that designed for the storing of very large file with streaming data access pattern running onto the cluster of commodity hardwares. What data you are storing into the HDFS that is able to process, and the data are stored into the cluster, which each cluster have a set of nodes. Node stand for the computers, which have a which stand of configurations. That is, they all are the commodity hardwares. They all have a commodity hardware. Commodity means normally all the computer have. If we are buying the normal computers from the market, what configuration you will get, that all we can call as a commodity. We do not need any special configurations. We do not require that this much RAM we require, this much hard disk we require. No, you don't need. If you have 14 GB of computer, it's enough. If you have 400 GB of space, that is also enough. If you have 4 GB of space, that is also enough. That all we can call as a commodity hardware. Right? So that is called the commodity hardware. The cluster of commodity hardware. That means HDFS run onto the commodity hardware. The simple point here we need to discuss that HDFS is run onto the commodity hardware. It does not require any special configurations. Right? Okay. Now what Hadoop can do? Why HDFS can do? So very first point that keep in mind that HDFS is able to process a very large file. The first point here. The HDFS is for very large file. So what they return, that very large means what? In the context means a file that are 100 of MB. See, we are not talking about the KBs. We are not talking about the 1 or 2 MBs, we are talking about the 100 of MBs. 100 of MB means the GB, TB of data. Right? So here the large means what? Large means in the context of that are 100 of MB or a GB or a TB of data. Size of the data should be what? The 100 of GB, 100 of MB and 100 of TB. That kind of data are to be processed or are to be stored into the HDFS. Right. So because we need to process the data, before that we need to store the data. And HDFS is working with the very large file system. Right. So there are Hadoop cluster running today that store the petabyte of data. Nowadays the Hadoop are able to process the PB of data. And even though now a version of 3, they are able to the iota of data, zeta of data, the version of the storing unit, that is the petabyte, iota byte, zeta byte, these are the storing unit of the computers storing, right? So nowadays the Hadoop are able to process the iota byte of data, zeta byte of the data, right? So that is the capacity of the Hadoop. Second point, the streaming data access. Streaming means to process the data. Right. So HDFS is built around the idea that most efficient data processing patterns. We have already discussed this point as well. There is one, the simple definition of HDFS, or we can call that one of the thumb rule that you need to remember for the HDFS. Write once, read as many you want, don't try to update it. Lakhi sako ek var, vaanchi sako ghani badi var, sudhari sako ek pan var nahi. Write once, read multiple times, it will never change again. This is a simple reverse, that is called the streaming. Why this happens? Because If you are continue, because Hadoop are able to process the large data set, right? The 100 of MB, 100 of GB of data going to store into the HDFS. And suppose you want to change that data, then attain, that means we need to attain to store, reload that all the 100 GB of data. One space for the old data and one space is required for the new data. It's better to remodify it. You are inserting the new data. Right. Because what happened? Firstly, they need to process all the old data. Then they are do the operation of the modifications. And then again they are going to store the data. It's better to do this. You are inserting the new data. Right. So the HDFS has one key definition that write once, read many times better, but never try to change. A database is typically generated or copied from the source, and then various analyses are performed on the data set over time. That is the work of the HDFS, the why HDFS is very much important. The questions will be arise that if we are not able to modify the data set, that what is the use of data which I need to store? So basically, the data always be helpful for what? For analysis, for taking the decisions. That's why we need the data. For modification of the data, we have a database. We have RDBMS. But if we are talking about the data warehouse, the data warehouse not for modification, data warehouse for the analysis. The same concept over here, HDFS able to large data set, no need to modify it again. You can do read as many at time, you can write once, but don't, you are not able to modify it. Why? Because the HDFS, the major concept is what? To analyze the data. You can analyze, you can process the data for the result. When we do the practicals, you will get more ideas about the same. So each analysis will involve a large proportions. That means if we are firing some query, you will not get one or two rows. You will get the thousand of rows. That means when we are starting to analyze the data using the HDFS, you will get the larger propositions, larger data. It if not all of the data sets, so the time to read the whole data set is more important than the latency in reading the first records. Now that is very much important. What they said, the HDFS working to process the data not only for single record, for all the records. If I want to set the roll number 1, how many time it will take? 1 second. If I want to count 1 to 100, it will take some time. That is done by the HDFS. HDFS not performing their operation on the basis of first record. They analyze all the records from first to last. So that means the processing time of the HDFS is also be higher than comparing with the normal data processing which done into the RDBMS tool. Right. That will also, when we start the practicals, we'll also write this answer when we do the practicals, that how much time it will take when we are processing the large data set into the HDFS. Then again, the same concept we have been earlier discussed, that commodity hardwares. Commodity hardware means what? Hadoop does not require any expensive hardwares. It is highly reliable onto the normal hardwares which we are using the in our normal computer system, which are using. Right? So you do not require to purchase any high configured hardware. So the cost of hardware is very less as comparing the different architectures of the data processing or data storing. So Hadoop HDFS is very much suitable for the commodity hardwares. But here's another concept. It is designed to run on the cluster of commodity hardwares, commonly available hardware that can be obtained from the multiple vendors, three for which the chance of node failure across the cluster is high, at least for the large clusters. Now what they did, what is said that we are using the normal commodity hardwares, right? But the major problem with these commodity hardwares or this distributed HDFS, that the failure of the node is very, the chance of node failure is very high, because when we are processing the large data set, when we are storing the large data set, and if the large where we actually store the large data set at that time, suppose a node failure will occur, then you will lost everything. That problem might be occurred when we are processing the large data set. It's a day, it's a little bit of a view, so part one chance not a પૈસાને 500 થેલી લઈને જતા હોઈએ તો પડી જવાનો, ફાટી જવાનો, તૂટી જવાનો ભય વધારે રહે. This is the concept over here. Right. If we are processing the small data set, don't worry about the node failure. The chance of the node failure is very low. But when we are processing the large data set, the chance of the failure is very much high. Now what to do? What is the solution for that? So the solution now we will introduce. So the solution is to the replication. Now before we see the replications, what you are not able to process in the HDFS? See, here we see what we can do the process. The first, what we have been seen, what we can process. We can process the large file. We can able to process the streaming of data access. We are able to process the data onto the commodity hardwares. Now what we can't, what we can't do onto the HDFS. So onto the HDFS, we are not able to process low latency data. Low latency of the data access means what? Small data set. We are not able to process a small data set onto the HDFS. Totally opposite terminology over here. HDFS are for the large data set. That means HDFS is not for the
small,
is not for the small data set. Are you clear? In the first point, what we discussed, that HDFS for the large data set, and here we are saying the same thing, that HDFS is not for the low latency of the data, means small data set. Second point, lost of small file. હું એવું કહું છે સાહેબ, તમે દીધું બરાબર, નાની ફાઇલ પ્રોસેસ ના થાય, પણ 1 MB ની 100 ફાઇલ મૂકી દો તો ચાલે ના ચાલે? નો, it is not allowed to process. You have, suppose you have 1000 of file, it is good, but all the file have a small data, all the file contain 1 byte of data, it is also not for the HDFS. That kind of data is not suitable for the HDFS. You need to process the large data set, and each data set or each the file contain the 100 MB of data, 100 GB of data, 100 TB of data. For them we have HDFS, not for the small file, not for a bulk of small files, not only for the small file, even not for a bulk of small file. Are you understand? That is the concept over here. A lot of small file is also not good for the, because it will take lot many times to process that all the data, right? It better to process the individual data by storing the individual files. We are storing all the data together and made one large file. It's better to do a process. This is the concept given by the HDFS. How pade jisu samjhao what I am trying to explain. Now just trying to understand. If we have 1 MB of data, 1 KB of data. We have a suppose 1000 of files which contain only a KB of data. So each file need to read, each file need to write individually. It will take lot many times. But better than we are storing all these 100 file into one common file. So it's better to individually to process the 100 KB of data as a 1 KB. You are compress all the 1 KB together and make 1 MB of file. Better to process this thing. Are you understand? This is the concept provided by the HDFS. That means it's very simple definitions. That HDFS not for small data. HDFS not for the small file. HDFS is only for large data set and onto the large files. Data set means multiple file. Right? That is a concept provided by the HDFS. Multiple writer. Arbitrary file modification is not allowed in HDFS. We have been already discussed. You can write once, read as many as you want, but you can't modify it. Not for temporary or not for permanent as well. It can't modify a file which already write once. Once you write, that means committed. You can't modify it again. Yes, but you can read. You can read as many you want. That is the third thing that we need to keep in mind, that modifications of the file is not allowed here. It is not fit. It is not good for the HDFS. So whatever three advantages of the HDFS, the same opposite, we have a disadvantage, or we can call the not worth for the HDFS. Not we can call the disadvantage, we can call the not worth for the HDFS. What is good for the HDFS? HDFS for the large file, HDFS for the high access speed, HDFS for the commodity hardware. Third, next, what is not good for the HDFS? Low latency of the data, lot of small files, and second one is the modification of the files. The three things is not worth for the HDFS. Right? Now, the next we are discussing about the HDFS concept. Before that, we are taking one small break. Right? So, the 5-minute break will be there.
Yeah.
Okay, let me start. So the HDFS concept, up to that what we have been complete, that what is the HDFS, which one is suitable for the HDFS, which one not for the HDFS. Now we have been already discussed that HDFS is working as a distributed file system, right? Up to that we have been discussed about that HDFS is working as a distributed file system. Now the next concept of the HDFS file system, that every file has a set of blot. Every file is not storing that content as a one blot or as a one file. The one file is also distributed among the multiple blot. Small blot will be generated, that is called as a part file. In the HDFS, that we are calling as a part file. Right? When we are implementing that concept as a practicals, so we can find out that when we are storing something, right? When we are storing one single file into the HDFS, that one file are distributed among the multiple part file. Right. So in the same concept here, in the normal file system, the file system has a set of blot. So that blot is the part of the file systems. So that they want to say that a disk has a blot size. When we are talking about the blot, one file are able to when the one file are going to store onto the disk, so that file are distributed among the multiple blot, the first thing. So how to define the blob? The second and very important point over here, that how to define the blob and its size. The very much important that the size of the blob. If we are not able to fix the size of the blob, then what happened that one blob have a 500 MB capacity to store the data. One blob has a capacity of 10 MB of data. One blob has 100 MB of the data. This kind of mismatch will be occur if suppose the blob size is not fits onto the file system. So what HDFS will does? So here they are written the normal disk blob size are 512 bytes. If we are using the normal distributed file system, normal disk, not for the HDFS, we are not talking about the HDFS, but suppose we are talking about the normal HDFS, normal distributed file system. So that file system, when they are generating the blob, so each blob contains the 512 bytes of data. But when we are talking about the HDFS, so in the HDFS, there is a three version that we have been already discussed, version 0 and version 1. And in version 2, there is total three version that we have been discussed, and now onward we have three. Hadoop version 0, Hadoop version 1, Hadoop version 2, and Hadoop version 3. And all they have their subversions, 1.1, 1.2, 1.3. But the main super version is 1, 2, 0, and 3. The four main version is there in the Hadoop. Now in the Hadoop, because why we am talking about Hadoop, because Hadoop has a two concepts, storing and processing. Storing is called the HDFS and processing is called the MapReduce. Right. Here we are talking about the storing the data. So Hadoop have a storing concept about the blob, about the disk blob. So in the version 0 and 1, Hadoop have a concept of the HDFS for storing the data. In the HDFS, they are using the distributed file system, and in the distributed file system, they are also generating the blob, and each blob have maximum 64 MB of size. In version 0 and 1, in HDFS, each blob have maximum capacity for storing the data is 64 MB of data. Now the questions will be arise. See, suppose that each blob is able to store only 64 MB of data, and suppose I need to process the 100 GB of data, but how much blob will be generated? Yes, it will. It will generate the thousand of blob. It might be possible that all the thousand of blob will be generated onto the different machines or nodes. That is also possible. So don't worry. Why you are worried? We should not be worried about the storing. That is the work done by the HDFS, and he will do. It will do their work. Right. My work is what? To process the data and to store the data. That I will do. I will give the data. I will take the data. That is the work done by the developers. You are given something. Do some operations and you fetch something. That is work done by the developers. So I am worried about only that work. That what I need to store or what I need to process. How to process? Where to process? On which machine will be processed or storage? We don't worry. You do not worry about that. That Hadoop will do internally. But the limitation is there that every blob of the HDFS contains the 64 MB of size. That is maximum capacity. But that means not that every time that 64 MB will be full. That is also a point. Suppose I want to process the 100 MB of data. we need to create the two block. We need to process the 100 MB of data. So out of 100 of MB of data, the 64 GB will be stored at block number 1. We can call as a B1. Second one is a B2. So block number 1 will store 64 MB and remain all the data. How many will be remain? 36 MB. It's remain that 36 MB will be stored over here. So how many sizes remain for block 2? 64 minus 32. Sorry, 36. How many will be remain? 28 MB remain. That 28 MB might be possible, it will occupy to another process or to another data. But the capacity of the storing of each block is 64. Why I am explaining this over here? Because the questions will be arise, the wastage of memory. Okay, suppose the same question that I was explaining right now before a minute, that the 100 of MB of data that I need to store into the HDFS, and as you said that the two block will be there, right? Because the each block have a capacity of 64 MB. For the 100 MB, we need at least the two block and two block capacity to process the 128 MB of data. But combination of two block, we are able to process maximum 128 MB of data, because each block are able to process 64 MB. That means two blocks are able to process 128 MB. That means clear? One block are able to process, now see. Right, HDFS store data using the block. Yet they are generated in the block onto the file system. On which file system? HDFS file system. They are creating the block for storing the data. In version, right now I am talking about the version 0 and 1. In Hadoop version 0 and 1, each block maximum capacity 64 MB. Suppose I need to process 100 MB of data. I need to process 100 MB of data. That means how many blocks will be generated onto the HDFS? One block are able to process 64 MB. I want to process 100 MB of data. That means how many blocks will be generated? Two. Why? Because we have more than 64 MB of data. The first point, that means it is not enough for processing that 100 MB data onto the one block. First point. Second, because of the more than 64 MB and less than of 128 MB, but still we require two blocks. Right? Because the one block are able to process 64 MB, we have 100 MB of data. So we need at least the two block. So we require the two block. That means 64 multiplied by 2. That means we have 28 MB of block. But here we are processing only 100 MB. We are processing only 100 MB of data using the two block. How many remain? 28 MB space is remain in block 2, or might be the combination 2 or the combinations of 1 and 2. It might be possible. Because we don't know that where actually all the data will be stored. It might be possible the 64 MB data will be stored into the block 1 and Saturn will contain only 36 MB of data. certain possibilities will be there that one block contain 50 MB and certain block contain the 50 MB. That we don't know. But overall, the 28 MB of data will be, the 28 MB of space will be remain. Right? So that 28 MB of block space, it might be possible to occupy for another data storage. Because of this concept of HDFS, your wasting of memory, we can call the memory leak, we can also call the memory leak or wasting of memory, it's not possible over here. Right? Because the HDFS is very much conscious about the memory, and it will work very efficiently with the memory management as well. They know the value of memories. They know the value of money of the memory. That's why they are able to process onto the commodity hardware. Right? So, here the points will be very much clear that to process the 100 MB of data, if we are using the Hadoop version 0 or 1, so each block have a capacity of to process the 64 MB of data. And we have 100 MB of data, so we require how many block? 2 block. Now suppose we are using the Hadoop version 2 or 3. Hadoop version 2 or 3. So the capacity was revised in Hadoop 2. What? In Hadoop, version 2 and 3, the block size is 128 MB, because the data is voluminous and is velocity. Data is velocity and voluminous. Data is frequently trained into the HDFS. And not only to come into the HDFS, they are come with the voluminous form, the large data sets. But due to these problems, they have revised that block capacity to store in the data. So before, in earlier version in 0 and 1, the capacity of block is 64 MB. That revised in the version 2 and 3 by the capacity of 128 MB. Right? So that is the thing. You can check that how many file system is there by some command apps that you already learned in the Linux, right? So we are not discussing here, but we can implement when we start the practical with the HDFS. Okay. So 128 MB by default in the Hadoop 2 and 64 MB in Hadoop 1 and 0 versions that we have been already discussed. Right. How many block into the Hadoop HDFS? In HDFS version, Hadoop version 2 and 3, the block size into the HDFS is 128 MB. When in version 0 and 1, the block size was 64 MB. That should be clear into the mind. Now, for example, a 1 MB of file stored with the block size of 128 MB uses of 1 MB of disk space, not 128 MB. See what I am trying to explain. This is very much important point, that this is very much important line. What they return is, suppose you need to process only 1 MB of data. If you are processing 1 MB of data, that means you will occupy 128 MB of block. Are you understand? If I want to process only 1 MB of data into the HDFS, so the rules of HDFS that once the data need to process or data need to store, you need to assign the block. You need to assign the block. If I want to process only 1 MB of data or store the 1 MB of data, so I will assign how many block size of data? If we are using Hadoop version 2, so I will write the 128 MB of block size. How many size will be assigned to me? 128 MB. But I want to process only, or I want to store only a 1 MB of data. I want to store only 1 MB of data. But Hadoop have a rules, HDFS, when anyone will come for storing the data in HDFS version 0 or Hadoop version 2, so HDFS will given the 128 MB of lot. And suppose we are using the Hadoop version 0 and 1, so he will given a 64 MB of lot. Now the questions will be arise, that same question what I have been already explained you, that suppose the 1 MB I want to store the data and the block size is 128 MB, then what happen about the remain 127 MB? So it's very much clear the return. You will occupy, HDFS will given the space of block size of 128 MB. But suppose you are processing only 1 MB of data, so remain 127 MB will be occupied or will be given to another, for the another data storage. You cannot reduce the block size from 128 to 1. Block size is always 128 MB. But the what space is remain, that space will be given to the another data for storing the another data. How? Now we have, first we are processing the 1 MB of data. First, we need to process the 1 MB of data. We are using the version 0 and 1. Firstly, we understand the version 0 and 1. We need to process only 100 MB of data, 1 MB of data, and the HDFS will given the 64 MB of lot. How many is remain? 63 MB is remaining lot 1. In the block 1, which assigned to the process number 1, which I call the storing number 1, storage statement number 1, which given, which trying to store only 1 MB of data, and out of 1 MB of data, the block size of 63 MB still remain. Now next data will come, next storing operation will come, storing operation 2, right? The capacity of storing operation, they need to process 127 MB of data. The second operation which pray into the HDFS to store the 127 MB of data. So what he will do? The 63 MB out of 127 will store over here, and remain 64 will store into the block 2. I don't understand. What happened? જે પહેલામાં જે 63 MB ખાલી રહ્યું, એ 63 MB બીજા પ્રોસેસને ઓક્યુપાય કરવામાં આવ્યું, અને બીજા પ્રોસેસ માટે તો નવી પાસે નવો પ્લોટ તો બન્યો, તેમ તે એના ફાયર ડેટા વધારે હતા સાઈઝ કરતા. પણ લોજિકલી જોઈએ તો બંનેના 164 MB નો પ્લોટ અસાઇન થયો, આના પણ 64 MB નો પ્લોટ અસાઇન થયો. It's not matter that how many MB of data is processed in that block, but the overall block size is 64 MB. The capacity of the block size is 64 MB. In the second, here we will, or it will given the two block, and each block also capacity of 64 MB. Logically, physically what happened? It's not our concern, but for understanding purpose. In the second storing process or storing operation, we are trying to store 127 MB of data. For storing 127 MB of data, that means if suppose we are using the version 0 and 1, so we need how many block? 2 block, 64, and both block also occupy over here. The block 1 and block 2. How many capacity of block 1? 64. How many capacity of block 2? Again the 64. How many space remaining block, we are not concerned with it. We are concerned only how many block size will be occupied. So The answer was, if we are using Hadoop version 0 and 1, then the block size should be occupied 64 MB. And suppose we are using the Hadoop version 2 or 3, so the block size should be occupied 128 MB. That should be very much clear. Are you understand? Right? So this is the thing. Then HDFS blocks are large compared to the disk block, and the reason is to minimize the cost of SIP. SIP means what? SIP by utilization of the current values, you are moving forward for the next values. That is a SIP. You are finding something else. What you have, you are not trying to find the solution, you are trying to find the new problems. Normally, SIP what happened? A radio station apna tarta hoye 95.95 apna patnan ho apne MRS no SIP kariye nau shodva ji, which is available. You are not trying to work with it, you are trying to find something new. So that what happened, the PC ni capacity cha 10 MB ni, મારી પાસે 50 GB નું એક કમ્પ્યુટર છે, એમાં 10 GB ખાલી છે, મારી જોડે 50 GB ના બીજા ડેટા છે, તો બેટર ટુ પરચેસ ધ 15 GB હાર્ડ ડિસ્ક, 10 GB અહીંયા સ્ટોર કરો, 40 GB માટે જ ક્વેશ્ચન આપો, તો મારું ક્વેશ્ચન રહેશે 100 GB ની હાર્ડ ડિસ્ક હું પરચેસ કરું, 500 GB ની હાર્ડ ડિસ્ક પરચેસ કરું અને 1 TB ની હાર્ડ ડિસ્ક પરચેસ કરું, ક્વેશ્ચન ડિફરન્સ એટલે સેમ હશે. ઓલવેઝ ધ ક્વેશ્ચન વિલ બી ડિફર ઇફ વી આર ટ્રાઇંગ ટુ પરચેસ ઇન ધ 100 GB of disk, 500 GB of disk, or 1 TB of disk. Right. So, according to the requirements, they are doing the minimum cost up to the SIP. And how it's happened, that we haven't already discussed. Are you understand? We have been discussed or not? We have been discussed or not? આઈ અન્ડરસ્ટેન્ડ થવો પડે છે, નથી પડતી, શું સમજાવવું છે, શું કહેવા માંગે છે, સ્ટેટમેન્ટ શું કહે છે. સપોઝ મારી જોડે આઈ હેવ અ સ્પેસ, સપોઝ ધીસ ઇઝ માય લેપટોપ, રાઈટ, ધ કમ્પ્યુટર્સ ધ કેપેસિટી ફોર સ્ટોરિંગ ધ ડેટા ઇઝ 2 TB, માય કન્ફિગરેશન ઓફ ધીસ લેપટોપ ઇઝ ટુ સ્ટોર ધ 2 TB ઓફ ડેટા. And now I need to process the 2.2 TB of data or 5 TB of data. Now I have to say, here the my capacity is 2 TB, 2.5 TB. I am not able to process the 2.5 TB of data in my computers. So now what to do? So I need to purchase the 2.5 TB of hard disk. HDFS said what? Why you are purchasing the 2.5 TB of hard disk? Do process 2 TB of data in your computers. Remain for the 500 GB. You purchase that much, you spend that much money only for the 500 GB. Better than to us spending your money for 2.5 MB of, for 5 GB of data. Oh, sorry, 5 TB of data. Adi TB ni hard disk lai and 500 GB ni lai, farak chat nahi question. That is said by the HDFS. Are you understand? Yes. Utilization of memory, utilization of space, and to do the minimum cost of the sitting to finding something else solutions. Everything here I will manage. That is said by the HDFS. But the problem is what they said, HDFS said what? That is thumb rule. What is the thumb rule of HDFS? You need to process a, you need to store the large data set, then and then I am able to more utilization of the memory. Oh, my requirement 10 GB na data ni hoy and 2 TB nu computer line motu to su kaam nu. I understand my requirements just to operate the tally. For example, I want to just operate the tally, and the, to run the tally latest version, suppose the requirement of the 512 MB of RAM or 14 GB hard drive. This is the normal requirement, suppose. આપણે ઉઠીએ ના ના સાહેબ આપણે તો સીધા છે ને 2 TB ની હાર્ડ ડિસ્ક લઈ દઈએ 8 GB ની RAM લઈ દઈએ લેટેસ્ટ પ્રોસેસર લઈ દઈએ ગ્રાફિક્સ કાર્ડ લઈ દઈએ ડુડ યુ કેન પરચેસ ઓલ ધ લેટેસ્ટ કન્ફિગર્ડ હાર્ડવેર્સ ઓર કમ્પ્યુટર ઇઝ ટ્રુ બટ યોર રિક્વાયરમેન્ટ ઇઝ વન ઓનલી 40 GB સ્પેસ એન્ડ 512 MB ઓફ RAM And that computer you are able to purchase by spending only 10,000. And if you are going for this kind of configuration where 8 GB of RAM, 2 or 3 GB of hard disk, graphics card should be there, high level of processors, you need to spend 50 to 60,000. Right? So HDFS said what? What HDFS said? They are not said to purchase any new hardwares. They are worked with your commodity hardwares. The second point. They are worked with your commodity hardware. Are you clear? So, now the second point, now we need to learn about the main concept of HDFS, that is here up to today's session we have been discussed about the what is HDFS, what is the pros of the HDFS, what you can't do with the HDFS, how the data is stored into the HDFS, how many size of the block of the HDFS, how many type of file system of the Hadoops, that we have been discussed. Are you clear? Up to that, it should be very much clear. Now the very main concept regarding the HDFS is all about the daemons of the HDFS. The daemons of the HDFS. We are not discussing right now all the things. We are just do some brief introduction and we will discuss this into the next lectures. Right, so we will discuss into the next lectures about the daemons of the HDFS. Right, or Hadoop. We can call also the daemons of the Hadoops that we are discuss on into the next session. But the Hadoop have a total 5 basic daemons which is used in Hadoop 0, 1 and 2 as well. For the storing of the data, we have a name node, data node and secondary name node. For storing the data, we have 3 daemons in HDFS. Name node, data node and secondary name nodes. And for processing the data, we have a job tracker and task tracker. Right. So for processing the data, we have what? MapReduce. For implementing or for running the MapReduce, we have a job tracker and task tracker. For the HDFS, we require the name node and data node. So there is one pyramid. There is one two block. The combination of two blocks work with the HDFS and MapReduce. So one block. So one we can call the groups. So group one is called the name node, job tracker and secondary name node. And in group 2, we have a data node and task tracker. Likewise, the story and processing are communicated with each other. Name node is responsible for storing the lot and namespace. Namespace is what that we already know, and if suppose we don't know, we will discuss on next lectures. But the basic information of the file systems, its lot, that all the information is stored into the name nodes, and the data stored into the data nodes. There is one architecture we need to draw for explain in very much detail. We will discuss on tomorrow. And job tracker is responsible to process the data, right? And task tracker is responsible. Job tracker is responsible to give the instruction for which data you need to process, and task tracker is responsible to process the instructed data. So be very much clear. Job tracker will say, I need this kind of data. What task tracker will do is give the instruction from the job tracker. He will go to the data nodes. He will say that I need this data for processing. Data node will give the data, and task tracker will do the process and give the response to the job tracker that my task is completed. By this system or by this concept, the MapReduce will run. So that is a totally two groups that we need to learn on tomorrow. One is the name nodes, second one is a data node. Sorry, group one, that is the name node, job tracker, and secondary name nodes. And group two, that is a data node and task tracker. That we will discuss into the tomorrow. So up to that, today we will complete our sessions, right? So hope so you got everything. I am right. So
thank you.